We've reviewed some incredible wallets from Carl Friedrich, and today we're looking at their newest release. I've been really waiting for this for quite some time, the Vertical Bifold Walden. Now stick around as I'll show you how it compares to the Swanfield. As we've seen with other Carl Friedrich wallets, they come in this nice gray packaging. The simplicity is really nice. The color of the box is really good. Let's see what we got here. Looks like we have a card. I don't know what's in this. Let's find out. Carl Friedrich. Well, personal thank you. Nice touch. As kind of a luxury item, we have a kind of a microfiber pouch as we get into the wallet itself. The Walden wallet itself. This is the cognac color. It is really quite nice. Love how it just sits, kind of semi-broken in already. And if we take a quick look at the sewing, there's some things I'll talk about with this, not quite sure. And that, this really comes to where this is manufactured in a different place as their prior wallets. They've changed manufacturing locations. But with that being said, we can see we have an external billfold pocket. Looks like we have a pull strap. This will be a fun little wallet. Let's get into it. On the exterior, as mentioned, we have this exterior wraparound billfold pocket, capacity of 5+ notes. Really low profile for each is really quite good, so that you're able to have access to cash. We'll show how that looks in the cash and card insertion test. We go to the interior, we have 4 interior card slits, not slots, 1, 2, and 3, 4. This is actually a slot right here. But we'll show how these actually run into each other by way of cards on top of each other. And then this really is a capacity of 1 card each. This interior piece right here, this is a pull strap that comes out, looks to be leather. And that's what provides you additional cards. I'd say up to capacity up to 3 cards in here. There is a usability thing here we'll talk about. And then we have what's kind of like a ticket slot right here. Cards can sit here, might be your quick access, for example, but you know, something could fall out or you put tickets in here, whatever it might be. And that's a quick review of the features of the Carl Friedrich Walden Wallet. Minimalist carry on this is 4 cards, reasonable, probably 6. Company recommends up to 8 cards, you know, plus cash that we saw in here. And you notice that it did measure out to be about 0.8 inches. So that's getting kind of thick. From a quality perspective, this is designed in London and made in Portugal. This can be personalized with various colors, font sizes, and other location placement on the wallet. And as you noticed, I got all the cash in there, and it just sits beautifully. I mean, really no concern there. It's a full grain veg tan vachetta leather from Tuscany, and this leather will age and patina beautifully. It's a single filament thread that provides very strong and durable performance over time with this and the experience. The support thread at stress points is something that's a little concerning to me. I didn't really see them very well by way of the support, especially in areas where you would receive a lot of stress. Not like from, you can see it right here, which is good, but not the consistency that we see with the Swanfield. Well, let me pull out the Swanfield. Let's take a look at what that looks like. Here's the Swanfield. Set the Walden aside. This is wallet was made in Italy. All the wallets now are made in Portugal. As you can see, at every point we have stress point sewing that's done. It's double stitched to ensure that we have very, very good outcomes. The edge treatment on this is painted. From a pricing perspective, this is $150 US. From a usability perspective, the low profile billfold pocket on the exterior makes quick access to cash. You just grab here, pull out, and this little notch here provides a wonderful thumb access instead of trying to dig, because it is high enough to handle all currencies. And I love this step down here to get to your currencies the way you want. So, it's really not an issue. I've got, I think, 13 notes in here. We recently added the Mexican peso. So there you go. Now let's look at the interior slits. This is not uncommon with Carl Friedrich wallets, but you can see that they stack. They don't stagger. So if you want to have access to cards in the back, you've got to kind of dig behind the front card. You know, that's not optimal for sure. And of course these cards, due to them being slits, you can see you have cards stacking on each other instead of having individual liners that would protect one card from the other. Another thing to point out is with the pull strap area, we take these cards out here and we pull these cards out. Inserting cards begins to interfere with that little Passover bridge. It tends to catch on that front, and it's not really, it happens with other pull strap wallets like this, but this usually they make amends by that. And in this case, if you put it in flat, it will hit. And you kind of have to open the wallet a little bit more, pull towards the top and get it in. And then instead of just pushing, you really have to push all the way in to have the pull strap retract to where you would expect it. So what makes this wallet, the Walden, different from the Swanfield? Well, with a version of the Swanfield I have, it was made in Italy. Since then, Carl Friedrich has moved their production to Portugal. This was made in Portugal. And some minor changes have occurred, including the reinforcement, which I pointed out here, and then this prominent edge treatment. I'm not sure if it was meant for the Walden. The edge treatment is different. And where we have a painted edge here, which is fine, what I've loved about this Swanfield is what's called this brushed edge. This brushed edge is amazingly durable. It's tight. It's hard is what it is. And with that, it just gives a sheen and it provides all kinds of durability, more so than paint. I don't know how they did this, but I wish it was something that would have been on the wall. As I pointed out, the Walden comes in semi-broken in. The Swanfield does as well. And I think that's a great production detail they give to you, which helps a lot. It measures 3.9 by 3.4 by 0.6, and it weighs 58 grams or 2 ounces. Now, my perception of Carl Friedrich is they're a Swedish company formed by two brothers who, like most companies like this, found that their needs and quality of products they wanted couldn't be found in the market. So they went around and created the business themselves to make this happen. And that's kind of the reason why a lot of people go into business. They provide a 100-day trial on their products. That tells me that they have confidence in their products, and they're really excellent products. The details they provide in the production make this kind of a semi-luxury item, which I really like, and it does have a lifetime warranty. They produce wonderfully made, high-quality products that are incredibly functional compared to other boutique leather brands, and they're consistent. That's what I really like. And they offer this lifetime warranty covering repairs and replacement for functional damage of the products. It's a great sign, again, of the quality of the products they manufacture and their commitment to their customers. As you can see how it fits in the pocket, there's no issues there. It goes in nicely, comes out. It's a wonderful wallet by way of its size, and its capacity is equivalent to many others. So now let's get on to the final score. For quality of 5, really the construction, the materials, the details are fantastic. Price of 1, this is really expensive in my mind. Features of 3, they do provide what they have. Usability is a 4, even though there are some issues with cards going in the pull strap slot. And perception of 5. Again, great company, great products, wonderful reputation. And that gives us a final score of 38 out of 50. You may have thought that there were a lot of things I didn't like about this wallet. I'm just pointing out the items that you may find yourself. Otherwise, I do really like this wallet. I find it to be very useful. Hope to see you in the next review. Bye.